In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry free worksheet, Angle Side Angle, ASA, and Angle Angle Side, AAS, Congruence. However, before we jump into this, let's go over ASA and AAS Congruence. ASA postulate, Angle Side Angle, says that if two angles and the included side of one triangle are congruent to the corresponding parts of another triangle, then those triangles are congruent. For angle, angle, side, angle, angle, side states that if two angles and a non-included side, or a side that's not in between those two angles of one triangle, are congruent to the corresponding parts of another triangle, then those triangles are congruent. So ASA, the side is included, and for AAS, the side is not included. So let's get started with number one. Our directions are to state if the two triangles are congruent. If they are, state how you know. So that's going to be either ASA or AAS. And number one, the triangles share a same side, so we know that that segment is congruent to itself. So you can see here, we have an angle that's congruent to another angle, a side that's congruent to a side, and an angle that's congruent to an angle. We have an angle, an included side, and another angle that is congruent to corresponding parts of the other triangle. Therefore, this is ASA. So these triangles are congruent because of ASA, angle side angle. And number two, again, we have a shared side. So that segment is congruent to itself, and you can see that 90 degrees is congruent to 90 degrees. So we have an angle that's congruent to an angle, a side that's congruent to itself, and two other angles that are congruent. You can see that the included side is congruent. Therefore, this again is ASA. And number three, we have a vertical angle. So this angle is congruent to this angle since they're vertical angles. Since this angle is congruent to this angle, this angle is congruent to this angle, and the non-included side is congruent, that these two triangles are congruent because of AAS, angle, angle, side congruence. And number four, we have that this side is congruent to this side is congruent to this side, however, nothing else is given. Therefore, these two triangles are not congruent. And number five, we again have a vertical angle. So this angle is congruent to this angle because they are vertical angles. And you can see this angle is congruent to this angle. This angle is congruent to this angle. So we have angle, angle, and this side is congruent to this side. So angle, angle, side, angle, angle, side. So the corresponding angles and sides are congruent. Therefore, this is AAS congruence. And number six, we're given that this side is congruent to this side, and this side is congruent to this side. However, nothing else is stated within this problem, therefore these two triangles are not congruent. And number seven, we have that this angle is congruent to this angle since they are both 90 degrees. This angle is congruent to this angle, and this angle is congruent to this angle. However, we're not given that any of the sides are congruent, therefore in number seven, these two triangles are not congruent. In number eight, you can see we have vertical angles, so this angle is congruent to this angle. And from that, we have this angle congruent to this angle congruent to this angle, and a non-included side is also congruent. Therefore, these two triangles are congruent because of AAS. And if you're still confused on included side versus a non-included side, think of it this way. If we have a triangle where this angle and this angle are indicated to be congruent to another triangle, if this side was also indicated, this would be ASA because this is the included side, the side that connects to both of the angles. If it was this side that was congruent, then it would be AAS because this is a non-included side. It does not connect to both of the angles. So just remember that when trying to decide whether a triangle is AAS or ASA. In number 9, we can see that this side is congruent to itself. So we have this angle congruent with this angle, this side is congruent to itself, and this angle is congruent to this angle. And you can see this is the included side. Therefore, these triangles are congruent because of ASA, angle, side, angle, congruence. And lastly in this video, we'll go over number 10. The triangles in number 10 share a common side, and that side is congruent to itself. We also have 90 degrees, and we know that 90 degrees is equal to 90 degrees, therefore that angle is also congruent. So you can see that we have one angle congruent to another angle, this angle is congruent to this other angle and the other triangle, and the sides are congruent to itself. But notice this side is not the included side. Therefore, these two triangles are congruent because of AAS. And I'll stop the video here. Join me in the next video where I'll complete this worksheet, finishing out problems numbered 11 through 18. Also, if you haven't already, click that subscribe button. All subscriptions and likes are greatly appreciated, so while you're clicking the subscribe button, go ahead and give me a thumbs up.